Welcome to St. Pasco Baylon Church. Please stand.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to come down to 11th Sunday of Ordinary Time. And we're going to travel these next number of weeks and months during this time in which we hear Jesus speak to us. We want to grow in the presence of the Lord. So it's not an unordinary. It's just that this is the common growth of our church. And also today we are really being reminded that we're also, by our actions, by our words, sometimes planting in people ideas. We have an influence, especially parents to children and children to one another. People listen and they watch. And sometimes the things that we do hopefully are good and positive, will have a good and positive effect. But also the negative is also true. So right now we think of something maybe I did this week that was not the best example for someone else, even for myself. We ask God's forgiveness, but also help to do better in the future. And Lord Jesus, for the times I did not imitate you well, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, for the times I misled someone or sent them in the wrong direction instead of towards you and towards holiness, Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, for times I let myself down by not being the best disciple of giving the best example to my brothers and sisters, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. It says, without you, mortal frailty can do nothing. Grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches, tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel, I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the low tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered green tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land. It would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Often its own accord the land yields fruit. First the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields a sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To whom shall we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed that, when it is sown in the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. So in the last 32 years, I have celebrated hundreds of weddings in all the different parishes, in the Archdiocese, in a few states, a couple times in Hawaii, Cabo San Lucas, Oakland, you know, wherever there's a need, I go. And it wasn't my choice either, but I still went there. And every once in a while, as you're interviewing a couple, for some reason, there's a click. And sometimes because you already know the family, they were members of the parish. And maybe this is the oldest son or daughter. And you have an interview, and then you sort of, like I said, there's the click, a connection is formed. And that means that past that wedding, there's still going to be an ongoing relationship with that couple, especially because of the family. But as I'm interviewing those couples for marriage, I'm a visualist, so I begin to see things in them. Sometimes how they speak, some mannerism, something unique to each person. And so as the years pass, I get the call for the baptisms, or for the first communions, or to be a part of this celebration or not. But they begin to form their own little family. And after a few years of still seeing them, may I go over, and now their children might be 5 or 6 years old, and I notice the children doing some of the same things their parents were doing. How they handle themselves, some gesture, some words, good or bad. Kids imitate everything. Kids respond to things that they see and they experience. And parents don't realize that everything they're doing in front of their children is planting a seed within them that over time germinates. It grows. And whether it's good or not good. And to look at that and say, wow, what an influence. But also this happens in a larger form too with people maybe you're working with. Someone sees something that they like that you're doing. I want to do that too. We influence and we affect. And we influence on small matters, but also on large matters. Each of us is constantly planting seeds. And today we're hearing that story with Jesus of the famous one with the mustard seed, the smallest of all. But if you intentionally you plant it, and you cultivate it, and you water it, it will go to the largest of all plants. No matter how small, no matter how insignificant, something or someone can make an incredible difference in the world. For example, on the 100th anniversary of Abraham Lincoln's birth, cartoonist John McCutcheon drew a famous cartoon. He showed two Kentucky backwoodsmen standing at the edge of a wooded area in winter. One asks the other, "Anything new?" The other man replies, "Nothing much. Oh, there's a new baby over at Tom Lincoln's. But you know, nothing significant ever happens around here." Centuries before, that someone might have asked in Bethlehem, "Anything new?" And the answer might have been, "No, nothing new. Oh, they say a woman named Mary had a baby in a stable last night. But nothing significant ever happens around here." And when the child grew up and taught, it was about little things. Salt, a cup of cold water, a fallen sparrow, a widow's offering, a lost coin, kindness done for one of the least of these. So many of the greatest happenings begin in just such a fashion. They are no more than the planting of a mustard seed. Yet, in God's good time, the seed becomes a plant and puts forth its branches for the benefit of all. I mentioned at the beginning of Mass that we're now in ordinary time. It's not unordinary in the sense that ordinary, this is the time for us to grow with Jesus, but to take his gospel message and really apply it to ourselves. As I mentioned, sometimes parents don't realize that the things they say and do are being watched. A seed is being planted, and their children in turn will imitate the good and the not so good. The pressure is on. But it's true for all of us. So the question that was raised today is, what are we planting as we're living our lives every single day? When people see us, when people hear us, when people experience us, will they leave our presence, our time together, more rich, enriched by all this, or poor because now they witnessed something that wasn't necessarily the best? We all have our bad moments. We all have our bad days. We also have great days and great moments, but especially as we gather with family and friends. So the next time, and I'm sure you parents who have children, you look at your grandchild, you say, they do exactly what our son did or our daughter did, who in turn picked it up from you. And maybe you in turn picked it up from your parents. It's a continuous flow of hopefully good things and wonderful things that are shared from one generation to the next. Right now, all of us are influencing and affecting the next generation, even here in our community at St. Paschal's. But you don't live here. You live out there, and every day you're interacting with other people. What are you doing? What are you spreading? What are you inspiring with? How are you affecting? What are you planting out there? So I'd invite you today to think about that, to remember that, and say, wow, I think I'm doing a good job. Or, you know, I regret this. I'm sorry about that. And that sorry about something might have been 10 years ago. Go back and change it. Go back and recall it. Plant anew. Make a difference in the world. Friend, Jesus invites us to join him in the spreading and planting of good news everywhere. When we can do that, our world will just be a better place. Be careful what you plant. Do your best. Share goodness and love with everyone. That's what needs to be planted in the hearts of all men and women. And so as sowers of seeds in the Lord's vineyard, let us profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us call upon God, our hope and our strength, and rejoice in the faith that draws us together.
Our response is, Lord Jesus, hear our prayers. For our Pope Francis, that his prayers for Christian unity and renewal be quickly fulfilled, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers.
For our President, Governor, Mayor, and members of Congress, that the Holy Spirit inspire and strengthen them in their service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students and teachers finishing the school year, that prayer, Eucharist, and charity remain on their schedule throughout the summer months, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers.
For our community of St. Paschal, that we always aspire to please God and do his will, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers.
For all our friends and parishioners who are ill, especially Kathleen Johnson, and all those ill with the coronavirus, that they may be assisted by our prayers and be returned to health quickly, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers.
For all our deceased relatives, friends, and parishioners, especially Paul Timothy Hansen, Margarita Gonzalez, Alma McManus, Dolores Didio, and Louis Hung, and all those who have perished because of the coronavirus, that they may be gathered by the Lord into his kingdom of peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers.
For the parishioners of St. Paschal Baylon, and for Nick Giuliano, and our family's special intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers.
For our own intentions, which we mention now in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Loving Jesus, hear our prayers. Heavenly Father, hear our voice when we call to you, and grant these prayers in the name of Jesus, your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. My friends, let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, the sacrifice at your hand, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who in this offering presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just mentioned to you, you heard that noise. That's not a problem with the system. It's the wind hitting my microphone, in case you were concerned. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundation of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all that you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and giving thanks, broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. On the journey of our life, someone planted the words of the Lord's Prayer into our hearts and into our memory, and since that time, we've offered that prayer many times. Gather here today as one community, we now pray together. Lord, we pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy be always free from sin and safe from all distress as you await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen." Amen. My dear friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. our announcements for this weekend. 11 months ago, I had to make a decision because our celebration on Sundays was not working in front of the church. People were separated. The numbers were not. I said, you know, we need a better space. So we moved over here to the school 11 months ago. We've been here. It took a lot of time to get to people, set things up, but I think we were successful. But our time at the patio has come to an end. Okay, and so... So next weekend, we are returning to our church for all of our Sunday morning masses as well as Saturday night. And the guidelines just barely came out on Friday night, which I already knew most of them from the diocese, so we are going to follow that. And it was really mixed about the whole thing with mass. They're saying, if you're unvaccinated, keep people in a section and put mass on them. If you're unvaccinated, you can come to another section over here. I said, that's going to be very divisive for people. And still our people are afraid to come back. So for at least through the summer, we're going to ask people to keep wearing their masks in church. There are no longer going to be separations of pews. All the pews and the chairs will be open. I'm inviting you to separate yourselves. If you really don't want to be with 10 people in a row, don't sit with them. And move out. All the chairs are available. They're all covered in plastic as well. And so I want everyone to feel at ease there. Things are going to be changed along the way as well. We're not going back to the cup certainly anytime soon. Communion will remain in the hand until we are told otherwise to do that. The baptismal font and the holy water fonts will be refilled. It's your choice or not whether you want to dip your hands in it. There's chlorine in it. But the font, you can always do the font, which has always been circulated and filtered. Don't drink the water from the font, okay? Believe me, in certain cultures, they take bottles to drink it at home. So I'm telling them not to do that, and this is sort of a fight. So I'm telling, especially in the Hispanic community, I said, if you want to drink the water, we're not recommending it, but bring your own bottle of water. We'll bless that water. You can go and have a feast with all of that. So just a lot of things. And one of the big areas that we mentioned, which is I know it's a struggle here, is that the sign of peace. Officiate is being brought back with limitations. The only physical contact to be made, given sign of peace, is with your immediate household and family. Everybody else gets a wave, a bow, a kiss, peace sign, but no physical contact with anyone outside of your family. We're asking us to observe that. And so, because part of the reason is, and especially I'm going to address this to all our people who are watching at home this morning, because the thing has gotten so much better. The pandemic, it seems to be on, you know, the way down in infectious and all those things going on. And the Archbishop, as of this coming Tuesday, will rescind the dispensation not to attend in person. And so starting for next weekend, and I know many of you have stayed at home and are watching, are very faithful, and I'm so happy about that. I'm inviting you, encouraging you to come back to be with us here in our community of St. Paschal's. We are going to keep on showing. I think we're changing to the 10:45 Mass and 12:30 Mass. We're going to be live streaming. But that's really for the homebound and the elderly who cannot go or those who are sick. But if you're able to come, please come and join us. Bring your mask. We'll provide free sanitizer as we have been doing all those things. But we want to see you here, part of our active community. But most importantly, to come here to receive the Eucharist, which is at the center of our community. And that's true for all of us, that we're all, you know, encouraged. So if you know your neighbors who have been watching at home and they're able to come, give them a little push. Plant a seed of hope within their hearts. They might return to be with us. So again, this all begins next weekend, just in time for Father's Day. We're back in our church with the Father of Heaven Creator who gave us that building just for that purpose. Volunteers, one volunteer, outside the gate there. We're going to have a blood drive, and Gene Nestor Memorial Blood Drive next Sunday. I know it's Father's Day. Give a pint or two and honor your dads, okay? So sign up with Gene. He'll take your name there, and once again, to help us with that. Please don't forget about your Together Mission campaign. Maybe hopefully you brought yours today. If not, I'll take it any time, all right? If you have it at home, you want to mail it, that's fine. You can bring it next week, that's fine too. Just in case you lost your envelope, our ushers have more, okay? So they're here and they're over here ready to give you an envelope. We need to reach that goal of $105,000. Together Mission has saved a lot of parishes during the pandemic that otherwise would not have made it through because of that. And so your participation and generosity will be greatly appreciated. To everyone who helped being over here, the people who cleaned up after each Mass, the people who set up, people who contributed their time and their patience for your understanding and all that. Thank you, St. Pascal's community. We made it. God bless you all. Let us pray. At this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows a union of the faithful in you, so it may bring about unity in your church. Through Christ our Lord, amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. My dear friends, our celebration has ended. Let's go forth in peace and love to serve the Lord and one another. Thanks be to God.